her last speech from the Competent Communicator Manual. Her persuasive speech today will not be about food or her kids. Surprise! Please welcome Isabel Nieto.
Think back to the old days when going to the circus meant walking into a red and white tent. Smells of popcorn and peanuts. Sounds of children's laughter. The animals getting ready to perform. And then when you exit the circus, there were always the sideshows. Pay a quarter to meet the bearded lady. Or the Siamese twins. Or the man that hammers a nail into his nose. That's always exciting to watch. Those freak shows aren't really available anymore. Or are they? I can assure you for a fact that these freak shows are even more accessible to us than they have ever been before. Perhaps in your home, in your living room. These freak shows are no longer called publicly that. They are now, we refer to, reality TV.
Oh.
It wasn't always this way. Reality TV started off really well. In fact, it wasn't even on TV. Back in yesteryear, the first reality show was the original Amateur Hour that started in the 1930s on the radio. And then in 1948, began broadcasting on television and ran for 12 years. Also in 1948, another show called Candid Camera started.
Yes.
More recently, we started watching shows like Cops, Who Wants to Be a Millionaire, and Who Do You Think You Are, where celebrities go back into their history and learn about their past and their ancestors. But like all great ideas, there's always someone ready to exploit it. Someone that takes it a little step further. That's when TV gets trashy. And we start to see the freak shows. Stuff like Real Housewives from anywhere USA. The Bachelor and The Bachelorette. And then there's, of course, the spoiled, unappreciative, rich kids on My Super Sweet 16. Is that what we really want to see on television? Is this why we pay $60 a month for cable television? Is this how we spend quality time with our family? Who we let into our homes to influence our children? Mitch.
Yeah.
If your wife watches Real Housewives of Beverly Hills, thank you. Would you be supportive of her buying a $500 purse for your 7-year-old daughter?
I don't think so. Let me think about it.
Tim.
Yes.
How would you feel about your 18-year-old daughter throwing herself at some man she just met while competing with 25 other women for his attention? Why would anyone throw themselves at another person that isn't chasing them? What message is this sending to our younger generation about self-worth, dignity, integrity, moral conduct? And then there are the arrogant, pretentious teenagers that feel that a $1 million birthday party is owed to them just for being born. And they would just die if daddy can't afford the translucent sat in tents for the outdoor beach party, and they were forced to host their event in a lavish ballroom instead.
Oh.
Can you imagine your child with appetence saying, "I wish that was me"?
Mm.
Something must be done. Television programmers, the experts have already been asked the golden question. When will reality TV die? The true answer is really not likely. But remember, don't let this deter you. All reality TV isn't bad. There are still shows like game shows, Wheel of Fortune, family shows, America's Funniest Videos, and X Factor, talent shows, American Idol, things of that sort. All of these also fall under the category of reality TV because they're unscripted. However, it is the freak shows that I feel we can do without, and I'm sure you'll agree with me. But the only way to stop them is to stop fueling the fire and giving and watching these shows increasing their ratings. If you've had a horrible day and the only way to feel better is to laugh at someone else's stupidity, watch America's Funniest Videos and skip Snooki on the Jersey Shore. If you're feeling down and really prefer to judge someone else without feeling guilty about it, then watch American Idol or The X Factor and skip Big Brother. Let's put an end to the freak shows. Please join me in not watching the circus acts on TV. Don't watch the trashy reality TV shows, and instead, wait for them to wither away into the land of bearded ladies.